Hey there guys, Paul here from theengineeringmindset.com. In this video, we're going to be learning all about microplate heat exchangers, or MPHEs for short. These are the most advanced heat exchangers to date, and they enable heat to be transferred more efficiently than any previous model of heat exchanger. So we're going to be looking at how they work, where they are used, why they are used, and the benefits of using these. Before we jump in though, I just want to thank Danfoss for sponsoring this video. They have some excellent microplate heat exchanger solutions that fit a wide variety of applications, including their new Z Design series. Not only is the Z Design compatible with numerous refrigerants, it also enables a 40% higher heat transfer rate and decreases energy consumption. If you are interested in learning more about what the Z Design microplate heat exchanger can do for your cooling system, be sure to check out their website using the link in the video description below. Let's just recap on the purpose of heat exchangers and how they work. The purpose of heat exchangers, in general terms, is to allow thermal energy to transfer between two fluids without the fluids coming into direct contact with each other. The fluids can be anything: oil, water, refrigerant, milk, steam, etc. Although for this video, we are primarily focusing on microplate heat exchangers and their application within heating and cooling systems for buildings which use water and refrigerants. These are plate heat exchangers which can be used for the evaporator and the condenser, for example within chillers and heat pumps. When used for an evaporator, the vapor-liquid mixture enters the bottom of the heat exchanger where the thermal energy is transferred into the refrigerant, which causes it to boil and evaporate. This then leaves through the top of the heat exchanger with some degree of superheat. When used as a condenser, the hot refrigerant gas enters the top of the heat exchanger where it begins to transfer its thermal energy out of the refrigerant and into the secondary fluid, which cools the refrigerant down and causes it to condense into a partly subcooled liquid state. Traditionally, shell and tube heat exchangers were used, and they still are for certain applications, but then along came the invention of the plate heat exchanger, which is a much more compact and efficient heat exchanger. These can come in either gasket or brazed plate variations. Plate heat exchangers use thin sheets of metal, known as plates, to separate the fluids and create separate channels for the fluids to flow through and exchange their thermal energy. For this thermal transfer to take place, two fluids are used, a primary and a secondary, which both enter and exit through different ports. The fluids must be at different temperatures. The greater the temperature difference, then the higher the heat transfer rate will be. The two fluids will never meet or mix. They are always separated by the plates of metal, and the thermal energy flows between them, passing through the plate's material. As I mentioned, there are two types of plate heat exchangers, gasket and brazed plate. Gasket plate heat exchangers use a rubber gasket to separate the plates and form a seal, which directs the fluids into certain channels, as well as preventing the fluids from entering other channels. This prevents the fluids from coming into direct contact with each other. This type of heat exchanger can be dismantled for cleaning, and additional plates can either be added or removed to increase or decrease the heat transfer capacity rating. Brazed plate heat exchangers also use thin plates to create the channels for the fluids to pass through. However, they do not use gaskets. They are instead brazed welded, typically using copper. During the brazing process, all the surfaces which physically touch another surface will form a weld along that connecting edge. So by orientating the plates, permanent seals are created which direct the flow of the fluids and prevent them from coming into direct contact. Brazed plate heat exchangers can't therefore be dismantled for cleaning, and no plates can be added or removed. However, brazed plates can still be flush cleaned, and because they do not use gaskets, they are very unlikely to leak, whereas with gasket plate heat exchangers, these are going to have a higher possibility, although with good maintenance, no leaks should occur. Traditionally, plate heat exchangers would use groove plates which have these V or chevron shaped patterns pressed into them of different variations. Then along came the microplate heat exchanger, which is the next evolution of plate heat exchangers and the latest in heat exchanger technology, and they have been designed with energy efficiency and sustainability in focus. Rather than using the traditional method of grooved or chevron plates, microplate heat exchangers use small dimples. There are a number of reasons why this is a great design. Firstly, because the dimples spread the fluids across the surface of the heat exchanger much more evenly. This maximizes the heat transfer surface area, which means that there is more time for the heat to transfer over across between the two fluids. The dimples also cause the fluids to move much more turbulently, because the dimples cause the fluids to change direction much more compared to a typical chevron pattern. The reason turbulence is good for heat exchangers is because when fluids flow smoothly, which is known as a laminar flow, the fluids actually flow in layers, and the outermost layer moves the slowest and the centermost layer moves the fastest. Heat is then transferred only into the outermost layer. The fluid in the center can pass straight through and will carry little to no heat away. This means you pay to pump a fluid through the heat exchanger, but the fluid wasn't able to pick up much or any heat, so you therefore need to pump the fluid through again to try and capture all the heat that it missed. Turbulent flow causes these layers to mix, and that forces the heat into the center of the flow so it can be carried away, allowing for more heat to transfer over, so the efficiency of the heat exchanger is greatly improved. The size, spacing, and shape of the dimples plays a critical part in the efficiency, so these are specifically designed for the application required, as well as the heat transfer rate and the pressure loss. For example, there are specifically designed heat exchangers for the evaporator and the condenser of heat pumps and chillers. There's also more general purpose heat exchangers like waste heat recovery, perhaps from a data center to a district heating system. So depending on the application, you can get them in anything from 3 kilowatts up to and over 400 kilowatts. And depending again on the application, they can be either braze plate or gasket. The heat exchangers also use counterflow design, and this means that the two fluids will flow in the opposite direction to each other, and this increases the heat transfer rate and the log mean temperature difference, or the LMTD, which results in less heat transfer area being required, meaning that the heat exchangers can be made smaller. Like any plate heat exchanger, the purpose of microplate heat exchangers is to transfer heat from one fluid over to another, not to the ambient air and its surroundings. A lot of people forget this and do not insulate their heat exchangers, which just wastes energy. For example, if you're using these for a cooling application, then it's cost money to generate the chilled water, and if you don't insulate your heat exchangers, then it's just going to pick up waste heat before it's even reached its destination to provide air conditioning. Therefore, if you see a plate heat exchanger that is exposed or its surfaces are visible, then get it insulated. Check with the manufacturer, they should be able to provide an insulation panel with the exact measurements for the heat exchanger you have, and these can quickly and easily be removed should you need to perform maintenance. This will also increase the efficiency of the heat exchanger. Some of the benefits of using microplate heat exchangers are that it has reduced refrigerant volume. The heat exchangers are smaller, so your system needs less refrigerant. Improved flow means that the pressure loss is kept to a minimum, so the process requires less energy to pump water around the system. A heat exchanger has a higher mechanical strength, it provides a stable evaporation process, has a longer system lifespan, it's quick and easy to install, it's smaller, lightweight, uses less raw materials, has less of an environmental impact. It also has a higher heat transfer rate, up to 40% compared to traditional fishbone design. Alright, thanks for watching guys. Before we wrap up, I just want to give one more quick shout out to Danfoss for sponsoring this video. Don't forget to check out the new Z Design microplate heat exchanger by following the link in the video description below. Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. I hope this has helped you and you've enjoyed it. If so, then please don't forget to like, subscribe and share, and check us out on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, and of course, theengineeringmindset.com. Once again, thanks for watching.